Today we are going to learn the basics of iFix 5.8. Let's first go to the SCU configuration. Go into SCU, configure SCADA, and you can see that you have to enable the SCADA. Enable and IO driver name, have to select the simulation driver and click OK, and have to add it. Then OK. Have we got the simulation driver here and have to save it. Save as a simulation driver and exit. Once again, have to go to open the iFix 5.8 and have to go to the proficiency iFix SCADA. And they'll ask, there is no license key dictated, have to keep continue for 120 minutes. That's for the demo time, it's 120 minutes, I think. Proficiency iFix demo system is running and you will get the demo time. Here we got our dynamo workstation and have to put the digital tags and analog tags for the switch and slider operation for the filling operations. First we have to go to the digital tags, so we have to create a tag name. Here you can see the database manager. Have to click OK and delete the previous tags. Next, I have to add a new digital tag. Have to load it, add new digital tag. So you can see that digital input is here. Click OK and my tag name is SW. Next switch I have representing in the SW. Go to advanced, enable output. That's if you are not enabling the output, that output will not be enabled. So go to save it and yes. You can see the current value by refreshing here. It's open. Now the digital input switch is open, or the switch or the contact is open. And I have to add one more thing, analog input. So analog input here, you can see that analog input. Click OK. And I'm going to analog the input as SL. Feeding my analog through and slider. SN and go to the advanced, enable output and OK. Save it, yes. And also we can refresh the value 0.0, which is the analog, and I have to save it. Put here and save and close the database manager. Then we have to put a switch and a light and go to pictures. You can see on the pictures advanced pump OEM status, and have to keep take your dynamo sets from here. Go to the dynamo sets and you can see that switches on the alphabetical order. You can see the switches small or medium, or I'm going to take the large switches. This I'm placing the large switch, click and drag and drop the switch, and I have to give the tag name. Go to the tag name, click here and fix. SW is my switch digital tag name, SW and F. Okay, that's it. On the off status it is 0, and this is my on status which is 1, and click OK. That's it. And have to put the pilot lamps. So lights, pilot lights large. Put the pilot lights here. Don't double click, just click and drag. When you double click, the Visual Basics will pop up window will appear. And on off control is here, and I have to give the tag, the same tag, the digital tag, SW, F, and OK. Here we got it. Okay. And close this. And I have to put the a tank. I'm going to draw a tank, insert shapes, go to shapes, I'm going to insert a tank here. This is my tank. And I have to go to stamp a value data stamp. Data stamping objects, data link stamper. Here you can stamp your data link from the analog tag. Click here, fix SL, which is the slider analog tag. F. Okay. Okay. Here I can see the values, and I have to click the vertical. Fill percentage is vertical, and I'm going to give the vertical filling tags as analog. Fix SL F Okay, fetch limits at runtime, you have to enable that, and okay, that's it. Okay, and I have to select this and go to view for format tools. You can see the data entry expert. With this data entry expert, you have to set the slider entry, numerical entry, or whatever. Have to choose the slider entry. Slider entry fetch limits at runtime, write continuously. That's it. Okay, and here also this is the analog tag, and we have to go to the runtime next. I'm going to the runtime. Here on the home, you can see the runtime as a green man's picture. Go to the runtime, and I'm going to turn it on. The light is on as the digital input. The light is off as the digital input, and I have to give the slider entry and click on it. And you can see the slider entry here. They have to give the slider values here. Here you can see the slider entry is key, and you have the valued space also here. That's it. So hope you understand. Thanks for watching. Thank you.